लाइका, जब तुम्हारा डिवोर्स हो रहा था तो वॉट इज द बेस्ट एंड द वर्स्ट एडवाइस दैट यू गॉट फ्रॉम लाइक पीपल, फ्रेंड्स, पीपल टेलिंग यू थिंग्स?
वेल, आई थिंक सबकी पहली यही राय है कि मत करना. आई थिंक नोबडी आपको कहेगा कि हाँ हाँ प्लीज जाइए करो, यू नो. सो दैट्स द फर्स्ट थिंग कि मत, ये मत करना कि आप सोच समझ के ये डिसीजन लेना. सो आई थिंक आई वेंट थ्रू द सेम थिंग कि यू नो डोंट. आई थिंक इवन द डे बिफोर आई गॉट divorced, yeah. The night before I got divorced, I think even then I had my family sit with me and ask me yet again, you know, are you sure? Are you 100% about your decision? So I think that was something I heard all along, yeah. And rightly so. I think these are the people who worry and care, so they will definitely say that. The best advice, well, I think everybody said if this is a decision that you're making, then we're really proud of you, and yeah. And in our eyes, you're a strong woman. So I think for me, that really
absolutely
it kind of just gave me that extra strength that I needed.
That's the strength to be happy.
Yes, you know, and I have to say that I've never ever spoken about this. I would really urge a lot of women out there. I'm not saying that you have to get whatever, but if you are in that process, if you're in an unhappy marriage and that's what you decide to do, I think you should do it with a lot of dignity, with a lot of self-respect. Don't let anybody bring you down or tell you that you're any less of a person or a woman. You're just make sure that you're a strong, wonderful woman.
Absolutely. Do you think there's a difference in treatment from society, you know, when a divorced man actually versus, you know, a divorced woman?
Oh my God, that is like the biggest disparity that there is amongst the many other disparities that you have to deal with men and women. But men really don't have that. And I'm not somebody to sit and bash men. I'm not.
Yeah. Yeah,
I don't.
Course,
I have a lot of respect for the men in my life. I have a lot of respect for a lot of men around.
I know, and you have a son also.
I have a son, and I mean, so I'm not going to sit down over here and do this, you know, man bashing over here. But yes, it's very easy for a man to move on with his life.
Malaika, divorce as a decision, like when you're, you know, going about saying that, okay, fine, this is it. I'm going to, you know, walk out of this marriage, or I'm, you know, not going to be a part of this relationship. How tough do you think people find it to actually take that decision?
Well, it's never ever easy, like no other major decision in your life. And at the end of the day, someone has to be blamed. You always have to point fingers at someone. I think that's the general human nature to go about things. So yes, you'll always blame somebody, and it's never easy. But the person that I am, the kind of person that I am, I feel you rather, for me, happiness is the most important.
Yeah, of course.
And it's not just me, I think it's happiness of everybody around. So even if it means that I have to make or take such a major decision in my life, of course I didn't do it alone.
Yeah.
We're two people involved. And I think we eventually did think about a lot of things. We weighed every single pros and cons.
Yeah.
And then we decided that I think it's better off that we move our separate ways, because I think we'd just be better people. Because I think we were just two people in a situation that were making each other extremely unhappy, which was impacting everybody else's life around us.
Exactly. That's what my next question actually is, that, you know, when you have children in a marriage, and I think that, you know, it always has a negative impact, you know, when the parents get divorced. But I feel that jab ek couple saath mein bhi rehkar bhi khush nahi hai, I think that also invariably has a negative impact on, you know, children.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So how do you think that?
I think I would much rather see my child in a happy environment than be subjected to an environment that is completely disruptive.
Exactly.
And I think with time, I think my child is far more, you know, accepting and far more, you know, jaise kehte hai ki khil raha hai abhi, because
yeah, and I there's think, nothing more than a happy mother.
And he can see that we both as individuals are far happier than what we were in the marriage.
And he's
earlier.
Flourishing more.
Absolutely.
And, you know, and any child I think would flourish more when
and
they see
he did actually
happy.
Turn around one day and he did say that to me. He says, "Mom, it's good to see you happy and smiling," you know.
So Malaika, what's your opinion about couples remaining friends after divorce?
That's a tricky one, because
exactly.
I think some manage to strike that balance, some never. I think it's more when you have a child involved. I think it's always essential to continue having some sort of a cordial relationship.
There'll always be that bond.
That'll always be that bond. So I think more when there's when there are children involved, then you kind of still kind of maintain that. But
you've done it, I think, beautifully. In fact, maintained such amazing relationships with the family, and I know it personally.
And I think that comes from a certain sense of upbringing from where,
absolutely.
Since I've, you know, where I have grown up, and I think my mother's always instilled that in me, that, you know, you can't just snip ties off, or you can't just, you know, suddenly behave aloof. And I tell that to my kid as well. So yes, I wouldn't say that Arbaaz and me are best of friends or something like that. But I think we are cordial. We have a very healthy relationship, and yeah. it's, and of course our child is our most important factor yeah. in our
so
life.
Now my next question obviously is, how difficult is it, Malaika, to find, you know, love again or to date again after a long marriage?
Because I think every woman would feel a little intimidated yeah. about jumping back into that dating yeah. pool again. But having said that, it's not impossible, and I think every woman should jump back into it with equal, you know, gusto. But
yeah, and confidence.
Absolutely, yeah. I think you just need a little time to kind of, you know, back away from everything, get a perspective of what's in store, and go on, go out there, date again.
Get onto Tinder, get onto whatever, get onto all the apps.
Keep going at it. Swipe any left, right, whatever it may be. Have fun, enjoy yeah. it. I think for the first time in your life, you'll also kind of discover a sense of freedom.
Yeah. Meeting new people is...
I think even for the first time to be in a bed all alone, you know, is also a new thing, you know.
Well, of course.
I think it's quite refreshing not yeah. to have somebody, you know, share your bed or your space, you know. So enjoy that.
So what message do you have for all the young girls out there who think that, who are actually constantly waiting for someone to come into their life, you know, if they're single or divorced?
Firstly, stop waiting. Yeah. I think that's the most important thing that you need to do, because I think these are things that happen organically. They happen with a certain, they happen in time. The more you try to, you know, worry and bog yourself down with it, the more difficult it's going to get. So I just think that there's a time and place for everything in life. So, which means if you meant to find that love and you're meant to find that partner, so be it.
Yeah.
But having said that, it's fine if you don't find that person in your life, yeah. that so-called Mr. Right or Miss Right in your life. It's fine.